Hello everyone, my name is Mohammed Adnan. I'm a master's student at the University of Waterloo. I'm going to present our paper on the presentation learning of histopathology images using graph neural networks. Before I explain our method, let me give a brief introduction of digital pathology. With the introduction of digital scanners in the hospital, we have now access to a large archive of digital scans, or WSI. However, large dimension of WSI makes it difficult to retrieve information from these archives. Each WSI is a gigabyte in size and may contain up to billions of pixels. Although seen have achieved state-of-the-art accuracy in various computer vision tasks, they fail to extract good features from WSI. And because of its large size, WSI cannot be fed into CNN directly. One way to deal with this problem is to extract multiple patches from WSI. Each WSI can give us about 200 to 500 patches depending on size. Once we have the patches from WSI, they can be grouped together in a set, and then multiple instance learning algorithm can be used to train on the set of patches. So multiple instance learning, or MIL, is a type of supervised learning approach where we have labeled for a group of instances rather than individual instance. So this is in contrast to conventional machine learning where we have labeled for each instances. But in MIL, we have labeled for each bag of instances. This is very relevant for WSI. So each WSI can be represented as a bag, and patches from WSI can be represented as instances. So we propose a MIL framework for learning WSI representation using graph convolution neural networks. Our proposed method is two-stage. In the first stage, we convert the WSI into a graph representation, and in the second stage, we use the graph representation of WSI to get a single feature vector representing the WSI. So in the first stage, we have a input WSI. We extract multiple patches from the WSI. Each patch can be represented as a node in the graph. And each patch is fed to a feature extractor, which in our case is a pre-trained dense net. Features from each of the node or patch is then fed into adjacency matrix learning layer, which computes a correlation between among each other in the form of adjacency matrix. Once we have adjacency matrix, we can fully describe the graph representation of WSI. We represent WSI using a fully connected graph. So each patch or each node is connected to every other node in the graph. However, each edge in the graph has weight attached to it. So some edges may have higher weight depending on the correlation between patches, and some edges may have lower weight. So once we obtain a graph representation of WSI, it can be then fed into graph convolution neural networks. So graph convolution neural networks were recently introduced to learn a representation for graph data. So we fed graph representation WSI into multiple layers of graph convolution networks, where the feature vector for each node is transformed into different feature space. And finally, we use graph pooling layer to get a single contents feature vector representing the WSI, which can be further used for classification tasks or ANOVA tasks, depending on the problem. We tested a model on lung cancer subtype classification. We use largest publicly available data set, TCGA, which consisted of about 1,000 lung slides. We train a model for lung cancer subtype classification into lung adenocarcinoma, LUAD, and lung squamous cell carcinoma, LUSC. LUAD and LUSC are most common types of lung cancer which account for about 70 to 60% of cases. We achieved the highest accuracy, highest AUC value we achieved was 0.92, and the average AUC across all fours were 0.89. We achieved state-of-the-art accuracy compared to previous methods, as shown in the table. This validates that graph representation is a much better way of representing a WSI than conventional methods. One of the nice properties of a network is that we use global attention pooling in the pooling layer, which give us scores, attention scores for each of the patch. So each of the patch has an attention value attached to it, and we can then visualize the most important patch in the WSI. And this makes an inference more easy and transparent, especially for the pathologists who are very much interested in getting the most informative patch from the WSI. So in the figure, the top row depicts the higher attention patches, which are important patches, and the lower row consists of lower attention patches or less important patches. One of the interesting property that we notice is that higher attention patches have high nuclei density. So this property is learned by the network on its own without any supervision. So we propose a framework for MIL using graph convolution neural network. Our proposed approach is explainable and transparent, as we can use attention values to get most important patches from WSI, which can make decision making for pathologists more easy and transparent. Thank you.